You want to be a champion. Well, let me tell you, people don't want a champion. They want to eat cheeseburgers, play the lotto, and watch television.
Hey, how did you get like this? I want to know.
There wasn't one thing, I can tell you that.
Go on.
I just don't think I can continue to live in a place that embraces and nurtures apathy as if it was a virtue.
You know different. You know better.
I didn't say I was different or better. I'm not. Hell, I sympathize. I sympathize completely. Apathy is a solution. I mean, it's easier to lose yourself in drugs than it is to cope with life. It's easier to steal what you want than it is to earn it.
Yeah.
It's easier to beat a child than it is to raise it. Hell, love costs. It takes effort and work.
We are talking about people who are mentally ill. We are talking about people fucking crazies.
No, we're not.
Today.
We're talking about everyday life here. You can't afford to be this naive. Blood.
You've made quite a life for yourself, Detective. You should be very proud.
Shut the fuck up, you piece of shit.
California, stay away from here. Stay away from here now. Don't come in here.
Whatever you hear, stay away.
John Doe has the upper hand. Mills!
Here he comes.
What?
I wish I could have lived like you did.
Shut up. What the fuck are you talking about?
Do you hear me, Detective? I'm trying to tell you how much I admire you. And your pretty wife.
What?
Tracy.
What'd you fucking say?
It's disturbing how easily a member of the press can purchase information from the men in your precinct.
What the fuck? Put your gun down!
I visited your home this morning. After you'd left.
Help!
I tried to play husband. I tried to taste the life of a simple man.
Pull it away!
It didn't work out. So, I took a souvenir. Her pretty head.
What the fuck is he talking about? Give me your gun.
What's going on over there?
Put the gun down.
I saw you with a box. What was in the box?
Because I envy your normal life.
Put the gun down, David.
It seems that envy is my sin.
No, what's in the box?
Not till you give me the
what's
gun.
What's in the fucking box?
Give me the gun.
He just told you.
You lie!
You're a
fucking liar! David. Shut up!
That's what he wants. He wants you to shoot him.
No! No! You tell me that's not true. That's not true.
Become vengeance, David.
Ah, she's all right. You tell me.
Become wrath.
Tell me she's all right!
You made her a suspect, David.
No!
Just throw it all away, you know.
No!
She begged for her life, Detective.
Shut up!
She begged for her life.
Shut up.
And for the life of the baby inside of her.
Shut up!
He didn't know.
Give me the gun, baby. David, if you kill him, he will win.
God! Oh, God! Oh!
That was two scenes from the movie Seven. And without giving too much away, Kevin Spacey plays a psychopath who's decided to pick his victims according to the seven deadly sins. Sort of a vigilante. He's doing society a favor. There's one scene in the police car before that last scene where he actually convincingly tells his reasons for what he's doing. And by the end of his little dialogue, you're almost kind of cheering for him. Sort of. But you have to remember that obviously he's a very sick person, and you cannot go around just killing people according to your standards. Obviously, he didn't get that. But the last scene is a really excellent, extreme example of projective identification. Now, the naive detective is being set up by the psychopath. He's in handcuffs. He's in his orange jumpsuit that he's been arrested. And he's actually still in control of that entire situation, because he mailed something in that box to the location that he told the detectives to go to. So what is he doing there? He's provoking the naive detective, Brad Pitt, into the sin of wrath. That was the last deadly sin that he wanted to cover. But he's watching him. He's provoking him. He's even egging him on. Feel it. Feel the vengeance. That's projective identification. And notice the wise older detective, played by Morgan Freeman, says, don't. Give me the gun. Don't do it. He wins. Basically, if you kill him, he wins. That's what the whole setup was about. So there you have it. That was a really good example of projective identification. And it's a really excellent movie. I've seen it a couple of times, a long time ago when it first came out, but it's definitely worth a watch. So now I'm on to two articles. Can You Win with a Psychopath at psychopathfree.com? And this is written by Administrator Peru. The simplest answer is you can't. The psychopathic bond is essentially a losing cause for the victim. There's no question you will lose for as long as you stay involved with the psychopath. The only question is how much. Chances are that the longer you stay with him, the more you will lose. Furthermore, even after the breakup, you won't win for as long as you perceive winning as relational to a psychopath and his standards. Here's why. You can't win by seeing him lose, because psychopaths aren't ashamed of their failures. They boast and dominate others, even when caught for their crimes and in jail. You can't win by seeing the psychopath regret what he did to hurt you and others, because psychopaths lack a conscience. They gloat about their wrongdoings and take trophies to relive the pleasure. You can't win by persuading the psychopath he's a psychopath, since to him, this will only mean that he's more Machiavellian, intelligent, manipulative, and dominant than you and others. Whatever normal people perceive as horrible character flaws, pathological lying, manipulation, a quest for dominance, narcissism, and sadistic tendencies, a psychopath perceives as being human qualities that he excels at, which only make him, in his own eyes, superior to others. For psychopaths, winning means playing games with others, assuming fraudulent roles and putting others down or slandering them, the psychopath smear campaign, in order to maintain dominance. They are narcissistic in that they need admirers, followers, and people to worship them in order to feel they exist. However, they use and put down even their followers in order to play games at their expense. Psychopaths and malignant narcissists respect no one but themselves and love no one but themselves. They'd rather waste lives playing games indented to make others lose than accomplish anything constructive with their lives. Obviously, you can't win by playing the psychopath's silly power games. You also can't win by asking for or depending upon his approval. Keep in mind that he's a completely worthless human being, a fraud masquerading human qualities. Consequently, showing him how true your love was, how loyal you were, how much you've done for him, and what he has destroyed will accomplish nothing except reinforce the dominance bond over you. He latched onto you because of these qualities, and destruction was his main goal. He will feel great that he was able to get you to love him so deeply. It means that the dupery worked. Score. So now I'm on to lovefraud.com. Preferred prey, sizing up the mark, Sociopaths never hesitate to exploit a vulnerability, and there's a list of vulnerabilities here. And this article, I want to find the author, but I couldn't, so sorry about that, but I'll post the links in the description box below. Sociopaths divide the world into two groups of people, predators and prey. They are the predators, everyone else is the prey. Now, if you know narc speak, or at least my narc speak, what does he divide people into? Two camps, assholes and nice people. Nice people are who he can manipulate. Assholes are people like him that he can't manipulate. There are no rules of engagement. There is no compassion for the vulnerable, no sympathy for the bereaved, no mercy for the innocent. Your weakness is their opportunity. Do any of the following traits describe you? If your answer is yes, be aware that a sociopath will quickly figure it out and then use it to manipulate you. And I can identify with several of these that I used to be. I'm not anymore. Lonely. If you're feeling lonely for any reason, an empty love life, a deceased spouse, a solo vacation, you might as well paint a bullseye on your forehead. As Dr. Robert Hare says, the callous use of the lonely is a trademark of sociopaths. Insecure. Are you a whiz at work but lacking social skills? Do you feel unattractive, perhaps a bit overweight? Is your self-esteem a little shaky? If you have any insecurity, any self-doubt, any feeling of inadequacy, and who doesn't, a sociopath will find it. Trusting. Maybe you're not street smart because you've always stayed away from the street. Maybe you avoid politics, even office politics. And I'll interrupt here. I hated office politics. I couldn't play them. It's just not how I think, and I didn't want all that freaking drama. So the trusting one, that's me. If you generally accept what people tell you, if you're at all naive about the motivations of others, you're an easy target for a sociopath. Do you believe people are basically good? You better learn that there are exceptions. And boy, have I learned the hard way. Then they're successful. Perhaps you're wealthy. Perhaps you simply have a good job, discretionary income, and access to credit. From a sociopath's point of view, the more you have, the more there is to take. And the sociopath you run into may not be a common criminal. He may be your investment banker. Aspiring. What do you want? College tuition for your kids? A comfortable retirement? Maybe just a little excitement? A sociopath can cook up a plausible plan to deliver it. Even a get-rich-quick scheme will seem legitimate. Just don't expect to see your dreams come true. Trustworthy. You're an honest, forthright person. You take your obligations seriously. You would never dream of taking advantage of someone. So when a sociopath takes advantage of you, you won't see it coming. If you play by the rules, know this, sociopaths don't. Nurturing. Sociopaths have an uncanny ability to spot and use nurturant women. That is, those who have a powerful need to help or mother others, says Dr. Robert Hare. These women often work as nurses, counselors, and social workers. They tend to look for the goodness in others and overlook faults. Is that you? Watch out. I used to be like that. Long time ago, not anymore. Committed. When you give your word, it's good as gold. You see yourself as a good wife or good husband, loyal to your spouse. You stay the course, even when it looks like you've made a mistake. A sociopath will understand and keep bleeding you until there's nothing left. None of the above. Perhaps you're tough enough or savvy enough to avoid the pitfalls listed above. Don't think you're immune. All kinds of people have been manipulated by sociopaths, including corrections officers and psychiatrists who know what they are dealing with. Even honor among thieves doesn't apply to sociopaths. Everyone is a target. So, as you can see, I read those articles for a reason after those movie clips. The movie clip from yesterday about with Sharon Stone, who plays a psychopath, the psychiatrist that she agreed to see was taken pretty advantage of. Yeah, and he knew what she was. The naive detective who is spending his life fighting crime and crazy people, as he calls them, mentally ill, was also duped by a psychopath in the end. The psychopath made him a murderer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, think about that. So, Seven is a really good movie. I'll post the links in the description box below, and I hope everyone is having a good, pleasant Sunday. And I hope this helps someone today. Peace out.